Marijuana is the most commonly used illicit drug in the United States and is used by nearly 100 million Americans. Recreational use of marijuana simply means that it is used for pleasure. Tobacco and alcohol are also recreational drugs, but research shows that these are more harmful than marijuana. Americans have the right to smoke tobacco or even drink alcohol, knowing that it's harmful for their health. The recreational use of marijuana falls into the same category. Cannabis sativa, commonly known as marijuana, has been obtainable for more than 5,000 years and has been illegal for less than a century. Recreational use of marijuana must be legal, however, it must be strictly regulated, and it becomes necessary for law enforcement to be made. In 1930, the Federal Bureau of Narcotics was established and Harry J. Anslinger was named director. This was believed to be the beginning of the all-out war against marijuana. This is where racism comes in the picture. In order to draw national attention to the conflict that Anslinger wanted to generate, he used the idea of racism and violence. One can see that Anslinger was obviously trying to create controversy problems, mainly targeting minorities, leading straight to the prohibition of marijuana. In addition, Anslinger has gotten people believing that if you smoke a joint, you're likely to kill your brother, and that marijuana is the most violent causing drug in the history of mankind. The protection of corporate profits also played a massive role in the prohibition of marijuana. William Hearst, owner of a huge chain of newspapers, helped Anslinger with his iniquitous plan. Hearst profoundly invested in the timber industry to support his newspaper chain and did not want to see the development of hemp paper interfering with his investments. During the Spanish-American War, Pancho Villa's troops seized 800,000 acres of timberland from Hearst, creating his hatred towards Mexicans as well. In order to draw public deliberation, Hearst sold newspapers containing explicit lies about Mexicans. It's ironic that both Anslinger and Hearst hated Mexicans, right? After 2 years of preparation, Anslinger brought his fabricated plan to Congress and bringing in the establishment of the Marijuana Tax Act of 1937. In other words, the commencement of marijuana prohibition. We'll be right back.
Now when the sun come up, I'll be there to say what up in the morning. Brush my teeth, find that clip I've been looking for since last night. I feel so caught up in the bud, I float somehow in my bedroom. Turn around, see myself in the mirror, I guess I'm cool. And those happy thoughts in my head, I'm feeling like I'm Peter Pan. Minus the tights and the 30s, happy to see how far I've come. To the same place, it began in my dreams.